Good morning, dear students. I welcome you once again in my English class. In the previous video, we were discussing about chapter 4, the trumpet of swords. We did not finish the chapter, so let's continue the same chapter. This will be part 2 of this chapter. Since some weaver was sitting there near the nest, they were feeling insecure. They had a sense of insecurity. That means they were not feeling safe since one outsider was sitting there and watching all their activity. Okay? Then this male swan kept on taking round and round the whole pond, keeping a watch on a nest. And this ball, the sound weaver, was quietly watching the activity of these two swans sitting on a log. Log means wood. And he was speechless. He was spellbound. That means he was speechless. He didn't know what to say. He couldn't utter a single word saying that. Okay? He was very speechless. He was spellbound because he was seeing a two swans which was very rare to see, which no one was able to see. Then later on, after a few minutes, Sam left that place, okay, quietly, and he did not have an intention to harm these two swans, but he had the intention towards their activity. So he quietly left from that very place. These birds watched that the boy leaving that place very quietly. Then the mother swan felt very happy to see that the four eggs are safe. Now these two swans took a deep breath of relief and they settled themselves. Now this mother bird settled herself in the nest to keep her eggs warm. Why children to keep the eggs warm? Because after the mother bird hatches on eggs, keeps it warm, then only it cracks and then baby bird comes out. That's why it is very necessary for the mother bird to keep it warm. Meanwhile, what was the cob doing? A cob was taking round, okay, to the whole pond and keeping his eye on her company. Here company means what children? The lady swan. And keeping an eye so that no enemy attacks that nest. Days kept on passing. The mother bird, what did she do? She sat on the eggs to keep it warm. The weeks went by and no one disturbed her. And then she continuously kept on sitting on the eggs so that the baby bird hatches from the egg. Okay, children? Finally, one warm afternoon, the cob, who means the male swan, asked the lady bird, "Do you never feel tired, or do you never get tired sitting in one place?" Why did he ask this question? Because continuously she was sitting on the eggs. Okay? She did not leave the eggs so that the baby bird might come out. Then the swan said, "No, I do not feel tired sitting on eggs. Then the Pope asked, "Don't you feel uncomfortable to sit on eggs?" "Yes, it is," replies the lady swan. "But I won't have to sit for long because cygnets will born soon." Now, what is the meaning of cygnets, children? It means young swan, the child of the swan. The Pope asks, "Don't you feel hungry or thirsty?" "Yes, I do," said the swan. Now, the lady swan decided to leave the eggs for a few minutes. Why? Because she was feeling very thirsty. She pushed some loose feathers around the eggs to hide them and keep them warm. Then she stepped off the nest and entered the water to get several sips. Sips means to drink water. Okay. After that, she felt very good. Means she was feeling very nice because after a long time, she could drink water, leaving those eggs. But at that time, when she was feeling good, taking sips of water, she did not even think that her enemy was just around the nest. Okay, that red fox. Now, the red fox stood waiting behind a clump of bushes. Means what, children? A group of bushes, lots of bushes. Behind that bushes, this red fox was waiting there. Why? Just to have a chance to attack on the nest. Okay. Then the male swan was observing in secret, and he said to the female swan, "Look out! I can see the fox creeping towards you. You are in great danger. Now let's see what happens." Now, just then, when the fox was about to jump on the swan, what happened? A stick came hurtling through the air. Hurtling is moving at high speed, surprising everybody. No one could guess what was happening. It stuck the fox on the nose and he started crying in pain. And while turning around, he ran away from there with pain. The two birds could not imagine what had happened. Okay? Then they noticed a movement in the bush and they saw the swan who had visited a month ago, the swan weaver. Seeing him, the swans knew that he had saved them from the enemy, and they realized that the boy was their friend after all. "Ko-ho, ko-ho," said the male swan. "Ko-ho, ko-ho," replied the lady bird. Now, the male swan realizes that their enemy was bitten. It had ran away. So he started shouting in joy, in gladness, in happiness. "Ko-ho, ko-ho." That was the noise made by the crow. And even the lady bird, same noise was made. That was the noise of what, children? That was the noise of victory, because these swans knew that they had got victory over their enemy. Sam was thrilled, means he was very happy, and he walked slowly around the shore and sat down on a log. Log means boat. Now, since these two swans knew that some beaver was their friend, so they came out and they poured their head near the sun beaver gladly. And this very activity touched sun beaver. He never moved a muscle because he was enjoying that feeling, that love which was given by these two swans. His heart was full of joy. Then sun paddled back. Then these two swans paddled back to their nest and returned to her place. She felt very happy to be alive. Swan felt very happy. She was happy to be alive. Here I finish the explanation of this chapter 4, The Trumpet of Swans. I request you.